going down, YouTube family? It's your boy, Mike Macklin, a.k.a. Money Mike, the financial Thanos, because I'm snapping my fingers and I'm turning your financial problems to dust. Hey, I want to welcome you to my channel. And if this is your first time tuning in, let me first and foremost introduce myself. My name is Michael Macklin. I go by Money Mike. I am a personal financial coach. And what I do is I teach a very simple 5-step strategy to help you achieve personal financial success. Now, you can visit me at www.moneymike313.com to get more information on that. I'll be sure to leave that link down in the description so that you can have that. You don't got to remember anything. I'm doing all the work for you. All you got to do is sit back, relax, and pay attention to what I got to say today. Each and every Monday, what I do is I host what's called Money Tip Mondays. And all I basically want to do is I want to put you in front of some great information real quick, just give you a quick money tip and help you to be more financially literate so that you can make better financial decisions and you can achieve personal financial success. Now, all personal financial success is being able to do two things at the same time. The first thing is being able to fund your current lifestyle. Now, most people are able to do that no problem. You know, they go work a job and, you know, they pay the bills. But the second part of that is you got to be able to pay for your retirement years at the same time. And the way you do that is by saving and investing. Now, this is where most people get hung up. So this is why I decided to get out in front of the people and really educate you on how to make that happen. So today, what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk about the four things that is getting in the way of you achieving personal financial success. Now, these are four very simple things that you can fix. And this is what we're going to talk about today is we're going to address what they are. See, when you know the issues stopping you from achieving something, that's when you are able to now do something about it. Most people don't achieve because they don't know. So without further ado, we're going to get right into this thing. Forgive my reach. I got to grab a couple things here so I can help illustrate this. I'm going to use my whiteboard back here to put some information in front of you. So, hey, let's get right into this journey. The four things that's stopping you from achieving personal financial success. Now, the first thing is a very silent. This is a silent income killer. And that's exactly what I call it. The silent income killer. And it is known as inflation. Inflation, ladies and gentlemen, the silent income killer. Well, why do I call it the silent income killer? Well, ladies and gentlemen, because most people, they don't think about inflation. Most people probably don't really know what inflation is. I hear a lot of people talking about inflation, 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 but you really got to understand what inflation is if you're going to attack it. And basically what inflation is this. Inflation is big businesses and even small businesses. They can charge whatever they want to for their goods and services, whatever they want for goods and services. The problem is the price that they charge goes up every single year. And they do that, you know, to cover their increased expenses as they go out throughout the years. They're trying to improve the organization, maybe grow a little bit bigger, things like that. So what they have to do is they have to pass those expenses on to you, the consumer. Because the way they're looking at it is they say, hey, listen, if what I have is valuable enough, you will continue to pay whatever price that I charge. The problem with that is this. For them and for capitalism, it's not an issue. I mean, it's a part of the game. But the problem for the consumer, that's you and I, is that our paychecks may not go up as much as these new charges are. And what that does is it makes your value, your dollar less and less valuable every single year. So it's like these costs are slowly but surely taking money out of your pocket. Now, the best way to explain inflation is I want you to look at the gas prices. Now, if you were born, you know, around my time, I'm not saying I'm old, but I'm saying that the price was a lot different when I first started driving. I can actually remember a time, and some of my people watching, y'all may be able to remember this too. Hit the like button if you remember. But remember back when gas was about 69 to 79 cents per gallon? Well, think about how much that is now. is definitely not 69, 79 cents. Matter of fact, there was a time here in North Carolina, I'm actually in Raleigh, North Carolina. I lived in Fayetteville for a long time, Fayetteville, North Carolina, AKA Fort Bragg. But I lived there for a long time. And there was a time, I think back in maybe like 2000, when gas had got up to as much as $4. So imagine that, gas going from 79 cents per gallon up to nearly $4 per gallon. So now what does that do? Let's say you got a $20 bill. You know, back in the day, $20, you good to go. You can fill up your tank for $10 and, you know, get you a pop or, you know, get you a bag of chips and still have you a couple of hours, you know, go rolling or, you know, do some other things you want to do. Well, now $20 ain't even, you know, saying it might not even fill up your tank depending on what you're driving. So what that means is your dollar buys less and less. And the problem is that goes up every single year by almost 4%. But your paycheck does not go up enough to match that. So now let's talk about the next issue. Now that we done talked about inflation, the silent income killer, let's talk about the next issue. Let's talk about your largest debt. Now, if I asked you right now, in the comments, let me know what do you feel like your lowest debt is? I mean, your highest debt, excuse me, I'm bugging. Your highest debt. If I asked the average person right now, you probably put down in the comments, after you hit that like button and hit the subscribe button, you probably put down in that comments that your house or your car or your student loans or your credit cards, you probably like, Mike, that's my biggest debt. Well, ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you what your real largest debt is. And that is your taxes. Your taxes, ladies and gentlemen. Taxes is easily your largest debt. And let me explain how that works. Basically, the average American who works a 9-to-5, makes about anywhere from $55,000 to $60,000 a year as of the date of this video. So that's about, you know, $4,000-$5,000 a month. But the problem is, before you take that money home, Uncle Sam dips in and gets a piece. And at that tax bracket, at the $50,000 and above tax bracket, that puts your taxes anywhere from 28% to 33%. Now let's talk about how that's broken down. Well, first and foremost, your federal taxes. Your federal taxes is what, you know, the big government takes out to do, you know, stuff for the country, infrastructure, you know, things of that sort. And that is normally for the $50,000 and above bracket, you're anywhere from about 22 to 24%, depending on what side of that $50,000, $60,000 you're on. Now, also, you have to take into account state taxes. Now, here in North Carolina, state taxes is about 7-8%. So I've got 22% here, another 7%. I'm already at 29. Then you also have Social Security and Medicare. So now that combined is about another 6%. So as you can see, if you're in the $50,000 tax bracket, which isn't a lot of money, realistically speaking, but especially based on cost of living, but that is easily your largest debt because a third of your money is gone before you even put hands on it as a regular W-2 employee. And that's who I'm talking to today. I'm talking to the average Joe, the regular working man who goes to work every single day, working man and woman. So ladies and gentlemen, the first third goes to this bad boy right here, taxes. Now, let's get into the third thing. Let's get into the third thing that is eating away at your money and preventing you from achieving personal financial success. And the third thing is debt. That ugly, ugly D word, debt. See, let's talk about how that works now. See, when a third of your money is already taken out on taxes, what you have to do now is, because again, the cost of living on average is probably about anywhere from $40,000 to $50,000, maybe more. But again, if you're making $50,000 and a third of your income is going to the government, guess what? You are left with about $35,000. But like I said, after at the cost of living is about $45,000, $50,000. So think about how that looks. Think about how that looks for a second. If your taxes is eating away, you at 35, but you got $40,000 in expenses, guess what you have to do? You have to take out this ugly D word in order to make up for that deficit. So what ends up happening is now you take out credit card debt. You take out loans from the bank. You know, you take out student loans to do all the things that you need to do in order to live your lifestyle and, you know, again, progress and move forward in life. So now after debt is done, the second third of your income is now gone because, again, you have to make up for that deficit that the taxes and the cost of living has created. Now, the final thing. This one we actually have control over. The last thing that's eating away at your money is this. You are simply overspending. And forgive how that end looks. You are overspending, ladies and gentlemen. And what does that mean? Again, let's talk about that. Let's talk about it. Ladies and gentlemen, this is by design. Overspending is by design. See, big business has a plan for your money. See, whether you have a plan for your money or not is irrelevant because trust me, big business has a plan for everybody's money, the rich, poor, you name it. And their plan is to get you to part with your money. This is why you got advertising. This is why you have everything that's on TV. Everything that's on TV is designed for you to make an emotional decision to spend. Think about all the alcohol commercials, the vehicle commercials. They're advertising this lifestyle. They're advertising how much better your life will be with their product. And to make matters worse, they have found a way to convince us to spend our money every single month on something. They have a theme for every single month. Let's go through it real quick. January, you got New Year's. You got to get out there and celebrate the New Year. You know, bring in the New Year. You at the club or you at a lounge or you somewhere partying, celebrating. Or even if you're at home, you're buying, you know, refreshments and different things for your company that you may have over. That costs money. Okay, now in February, you getting double dipped. You got Valentine's Day because you got to take care of sweetheart. And then you also got the Super Bowl, America's biggest day, one of the biggest days in American sports, the Super Bowl. So what you do, you go out and get your wings, your pizza, you know, your refreshments, everything to entertain, host Super Bowl parties. Or, you know, restaurants, they're hosting Super Bowl parties. In March, now you got spring break. It's time to get out there and let your hair down. It's getting a little warm. And you know what? All these resorts and things, they opening up. They ready for you. Big business. Again, all right, y'all got to get out there and get on vacation now. You only get 2 weeks a year, so you better spend some time out here. April, you got Easter. The one day, you know, people get religion and decide, you know, they want to go to church and get fly. They got to get their kids doggone ready. They got to get themselves ready. They got to get new clothes. To go to church. And then now you got May, you got Mother's Day and you got Memorial Weekend. Okay. So now again, you got to take mom out to eat. You got to, you know, go out on another vacation maybe. And, you know, celebrate the warmer weather. You know, March, you got a little warm. May is getting a little bit warmer. So now you got Memorial Weekend. You go out, have a good time, go to the beach, whatever. Now June, Father's Day, you know, the fellas, finally we get a little day. We might get, you know, some socks or, you know, whatever it is, a card. But guess what? You're still spending money, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, now July, you got 4th of July, one of the most profitable days in the year. August, you got back to school. And even right now, during a pandemic, you're still being convinced to purchase, you know, backpacks and new clothes and all these things, just like, you know, ain't no pandemic going on, but somehow, you know, it's still a good idea to go out there and buy these things. You know, a lot of people now are having to buy laptops. The teachers are saying you need a new laptop so that you can do Zoom or whatever virtual way that they're going to teach the classes for those who are not physically going to school. Now, in September, you got Labor Day. You got Labor Day in September, the last opportunity to throw a barbecue before it starts, you know, getting a little colder. So again, you're buying refreshments, you're buying things to entertain guests. October, another profitable one-day event. You got Halloween. You're buying costumes, you're buying candy, you're buying decorations. November, they really hit you hard. You got Thanksgiving, you got Brown Thursday, Black Friday, Small Business Saturday, Cyber Monday. I mean, come on, they're killing us. They're killing us. They're convincing you on Black Friday alone, they're making a killing. You can't even finish your food and they already looking for you to spend. And finally in December, you got Christmas. Now those are what big business convinces you to spend. But then you also got to think about, you know, the personal things that you spend on. The wedding anniversaries, the birthdays, the graduations, the baby showers, you know, you name it. You know, all these different things that you celebrate personally. Okay, so after you're done, all of your money is gone. And again, the last part, this overspending, is actually something that you can control. So I say all that to say this, ladies and gentlemen. Let's recap on everything that's taking your money. Okay, first and foremost, the silent income killer, inflation. Your dollar is becoming worth less and less because businesses charge more and more for their goods and services, but your check is not keeping up. The second problem is your biggest debt, and that's taxes. See, when you get through paying taxes, the first third of your money is gone. And the problem is you don't even see that money. The government yanks that before you even get a chance to spend it. Now, the second third of your money is taken because of what taxes does, because now the cost of living is higher than what you actually bring home. You're forced to take out debt and use credit cards. And the way that your money is taken is through the interest being charged for those loans and that credit cards that you use. And finally, you're simply overspending what's left. The little bit of money you got left, again, big business is finding a way for you to part with it. So when you are left with zero or even in a negative, most people are left in the negative. You got more month than money. You know, as they say, you get paid on Friday, you broke by Monday. And these are the reasons why. So, ladies and gentlemen, I challenge you, now that you understand what is working against your pockets, now it is time to address those things. And as we get further into these videos that I do, we'll start to address those things. Or you can actually visit me again at www.moneymike313.com. You can set up a personal consultation with me. I will show you how to put together a plan to address all of these things. So as I part, I want to thank you for your attention. I also want to thank you for taking out the time to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and hit that notification bell so that you can get all the videos. You can know exactly when I'm dropping new videos. I appreciate each and every one of you's time. And as always, I love you. God loves you. He smiles when he sees you, and he sees you all the time, so he's always smiling. So why aren't we? Y'all have a better than amazing day. God bless you all. Go on.